It can only be hard if you're focusing on a selfish output. It becomes the easiest thing you've ever done if you look through the perspective of these animals.
Oh, yeah.
Because being vegan is easy.
Right.
Being an animal in these industries, that's what's really hard. Cage-free, grass-fed, grass-finished, organic, humane certified, antibiotic-free, no matter what the romanticized label is, this is the reality of what actually happens to those animals inside of those industries.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen footage like this before?
Maybe not this intense, but...
You've seen maybe
similar, yeah.
General slaughterhouse stuff?
Yeah.
And when you see it, how does it make you feel?
Oh my God, I mean, look at me now. I can't even look at it.
Yeah, you seem pretty affected by it. So it's safe to say that you're against animal abuse.
Right, yeah.
And do you think it's truly possible to be against animal abuse, but also buy the products of these industries?
No, I mean, well, I think the key word that you said that really makes me like think is because you said romanticized label, you know? So it's like whatever label you put it on, it's like I could go out and I could be like, well, it's grass-fed, blah, blah,
right.
Free range, whatever, but it'd be shit, you know?
Yeah, in actuality, all those labels are designed to make you feel better about buying them.
Right.
They actually do nothing to make the animals feel better.
Damn.
The same fate happens to the animal no matter what that package says on it. It's just designed to make you feel better about buying it, to deflect the guilt that comes along with these images.
How do they get away putting those labels on it?
That's all a marketing ploy.
Really?
This is all based on creating more levels of profit.
Mm-hmm.
These animals are looked at as commodities,
right.
And they have to be sold accordingly to make the most profit as possible.
Right.
So the producers will never do what's right by the animals.
Mm-hmm.
They're only focused on making more money off of them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that, I believe it. I believe it. That's upsetting.
So what we're promoting here tonight is animal rights through the means of veganism, which is a way of living that excludes all animal-derived products and anything that comes from animal cruelty or abuse. And as far as you as an individual, I'm guessing that you're from Boston or the Boston area.
No, actually I'm not. I just moved here from Las Vegas.
All right, absolutely.
Yeah.
So as someone from Vegas who's now in Boston, as an individual, what do you think are some things holding you back from not supporting these industries and going vegan?
My biggest thing is just that I feel like vegan food is so much more expensive. Like, I can only afford, you know, like meat, like animal products.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I hear that stigma a lot, actually.
Mm-hmm.
And if we're talking by pound, the cheapest foods in the supermarket are going to be rice, beans, pastas, potatoes, that sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
If we're talking by pound, beef in the supermarket on sale is $3.99 per pound. A pound of dried chickpeas is 99 cents. And you're actually going to eat more than once off of that amount of legumes. So the idea that the animal products are cheaper is actually a fallacy. And on top of that, these industries are actually subsidized. So in reality, they actually cost much more than that. But they're actually subsidized by the government so they can be sold at that price point. But even at that price point, the plant foods are always going to be cheaper.
Really? So I have two more questions for you. What about like protein, and what is your suggestion for like milk? Like what is a good like alternative to like just regular dairy milk?
Good question. Now before I go into that, I want to just first separate that you're asking me questions about the how. What I want to talk to you about is the why. Now I'm not neglecting those questions that you asked. But once you resonate with the why and understand who you're doing it for, these things are just a simple Google search away, and they're not as non-obtainable as people might think. But going back into that, I eat the same thing that you eat, minus the animal cruelty.
Great.
And I've been vegan for almost a decade.
Ooh, wow.
I'm not protein deficient in any sort of way.
Great.
And as far as any milk is concerned, you can have a milk that just doesn't come out of a cow.
Right. Because I've like always wanted to go vegan and everything, but like I'm not too good at cooking in the first place. So then once I find something that I like, I'm like it's really difficult for me to find something that I can cook in the first place, and then to make it like animal free, then that's like another challenge. But it's something I'd like to work on. You know,
yeah.
It's like just more research and more networking. Well, not really
Do you think it would be hard?
Maybe, like finding out, like, at first what I would need to do might be hard, but then once I, like, got into the rhythm of it, I think it would be easier, you know? Yeah.
It can only be hard if you're focusing on a selfish output. It becomes the easiest thing you've ever done if you look through the perspective of these animals.
Oh, yeah.
Because being vegan is easy.
Right.
Being an animal in these industries, that's what's really hard.
Yeah.
So do you think that safety net of convenience that you have is a moral justification to these images you're seeing here on the screens?
No. Oh my god, I feel like a piece of shit now. I mean, that's how I should feel, you know? Because you guys are doing this for a reason.
Yeah, and guilt is actually a really effective tool.
Right, yeah.
All of us here became vegan because we understood that our choices and our actions have consequences.
Mm-hmm.
And in this particular topic, the consequence is exactly what you see your animals having their heads cut off for a sandwich.
Right. Yeah.
If you feel that this is disgusting and abhorrent and something that you don't want to support,
mm-hmm.
then as an individual, you need to separate yourself from it.
Because I also feel like it, like if you can't sit here and watch this, then you don't deserve whatever you're getting out of it. Does that make sense?
Absolutely.
You know? Like if you can't, if you wouldn't be able to do this yourself, then you shouldn't be eating that.
And we always inspect injustice from the victim's point of view.
Right, uh-huh.
So when we want to define humane, everybody thinks that what they see on the screen is the most humane way to do this. The way that we need to define humane is putting yourself in their position.
Right,
would you want these things subjected onto you?
No, that's
and if you feel that you would never want that to happen, why would you project that onto somebody else?
Right.
Because you came up to me today and you seemed as if this was affecting you, and you said you were against animal abuse and animal cruelty. However, when you vote with your dollar and you buy products of these industries, you're actually pro-animal abuse.
Right.
And not only are you supporting, but you're funding exactly what you're against on these screens.
Yeah, dude. And it's like, I don't think much of it, like, when I'm doing it, because I'm like, oh, well, that's cheaper or whatever else, like, you know, whatever reason I, like, have, but I'm like, fucking no, it's not the same. It's, you know, I'm funding that because it's like it might be easier for me short term, but then it's like there's so much more that goes behind it, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Holy shit, man.
And do you know the number one benefit of being vegan?
What?
Like number one. Any guesses?
What? Better quality of life for those.
Nailed it. First, it's always for the animals. They're no longer subjected to torture because of you.
Right.
They're relieved of that as far as you're concerned.
Mm-hmm.
But as an individual, this is really important.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You have told me that you're against animal abuse and that you're disgusted by what you see on these screens.
Mm-hmm.
So when you become vegan, for the first time, you have the opportunity to not be a hypocrite. I just try to speak up for the animals in the same way that I would want to be spoken up for.
Yeah, and like at the same time, you're not like making me feel like super, like you're not like directly like telling me I'm a piece of shit, you know? It's
yeah.
Like,
well, I would never disrespect anyone individually.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just trying to get people to understand their accountability and their responsibility. And the goal with these conversations is to understand moral consistency.
Mm-hmm.
In the beginning of it, you clearly stated you were against animal abuse.
Mm-hmm.
And you can't even look at the screens right now because it's affecting you.
Right.
So by the end of it, I hope that you realize that morally, you haven't been completely consistent because you do support these products.
Right.
And when you leave here today, understand there's only one thing that you have to do, and that is to align your actions with the beliefs that you have shared with me during this conversation. Yeah. Being vegan changes absolutely nothing about you.
Right.
You're going to be the same person, taking these same photos, living your life in the way that you enjoy.
Right.
However, you'll no longer be supporting the most cruel acts on the planet.
Right. And in addition to bad quality of life, I've heard that it's actually like, I've heard that like the meat industry and the fashion industry are like the two most, like, leading causes of climate change, too. Is that correct? Do you know?
I'm not exactly an environmentalist. I'm not a lobbyist. I'm an animal rights activist. Okay. So I don't want to really take a left turn and talk about health or environment. I just want to focus on the moral imperative of taking animal abuse seriously.
Great.
And if it was something that affected environment in some sort of way, the only reason why it would affect it is because humans as a whole didn't take the animal abuse seriously.
Great.
And it became a problem for health or environment. But I'm not here to talk to you about putting a Band-Aid over it. I want to attack the root cause and not the symptoms. And the root cause is the animal abuse. Yeah, thank you very much. If I gave you some more information, would you be interested in some?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is our organization, Anonymous for the Voiceless.
Yeah.
On the back here, first, the best speech you will ever hear. It's free on YouTube, over 5 million views by a man named Gary Yourofsky. He's all of our mentors, amazing speaker, really gonna drive home the moral imperative, also touching on some of the other questions that you had. Dominion is where we pull all of this footage from. If you ever do want to look into the industries that you have been supporting. And then some of these other things are tools as far as the how goes. If you do need some extra resources, but I do want to stress that this is simple stuff.
Okay.
Don't go home and think that you can't be vegan because you don't have a laundry list of resources.
Right. Okay.
It's as simple as being disgusted at what you see on the screens.
Uh-huh.
And then maybe a couple
like
of Google searches.
Right, yeah. It's as simple as making a different choice at the supermarket.
Yeah. It's as simple as understanding your accountability as a consumer. And I want to leave you with this.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
What's your name?
My name is Jacob.
Jacob, I'm Sunny. I'm going to...
Yes, absolutely, yeah.
Well, I hope you know that you've impacted at least one person today.
Thank you so much for the conversation. And before you leave, just remember that until the day that you do align your actions with your beliefs and become vegan, that animals will be abused because of you. So just decide what side of history you want to stand on with this particular injustice.
Damn, dude. Man, you really impacted me. I hope you know that. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for the conversation.